The Nokia 2 is the newest affordable handset from the company, and we've been testing out its low-cost camera to see whether a low price tag means sacrificing on capability. Hardware. At £99, the 2 is the most affordable Android-based Nokia you can lay your hands on right now, with the upcoming Nokia 1 hot on its heels. Despite the low price tag though, the phone packs in a pair of surprisingly high resolution snappers. On the back, you're working with an 8-megapixel autofocus sensor sporting a fairly wide-angle lens and an f2.6 aperture accompanied by a single LED flash. The selfie snapper, meanwhile, is a 5-megapixel fixed focus effort, and that's just about everything HMD has divulged on it. UI and features. The Nokia camera app is arguably the most interesting aspect of the 2's photographic feature set. The clean viewfinder features quick toggles for flash, auto HDR, which is enabled by default, 3 and 10 second timers, and the camera switcher. The shutter button on the other side is surrounded by a gallery shortcut, video mode switcher, and a shooting mode pop-out menu, which lets you jump between photos, beautify, and panorama in the rear camera only. Flip to video mode, and this pop-out menu instead lets you shift recording speeds between half and up to 3 times that of real time. It's the camera's settings menu that packs in a few surprises. You can enable a compass and choose to have the data tied to your snaps, initiate an on-screen level, a grid overlay, and even drop in custom watermarks. You can toggle common settings like the shutter sound, location tagging, and burst mode, along with tweaking volume control behavior. What we weren't expecting to find on such an affordable device, however, was any level of manual control, but by fiddling with the capture settings submenu, the viewfinder will then display simplified controls for metering, focus, white balance, and even exposure. It's important to note that the Nokia 2 is a relatively underpowered phone, something we touch on in greater depth in our full Nokia 2 review. It's an issue that's particularly prevalent when using the camera. The app takes a long time to open up, and the shutter is far from snappy, especially if boost light is enabled, as it effectively quadruples the amount of shutter lag you'll have to endure. Photo quality. Overall, the Nokia 2's cameras lack dynamic range, meaning lighter areas become blown out all too easily. Not to mention colors consistently appear drab and washed out as well. The main snapper struggles to resolve fine detail anywhere in frame, but stay still and low light shots are actually possible. The front 5-megapixel camera, meanwhile, fares a little better, provided you hold it at the right distance. Assuming there's plenty of light around, you can expect usable selfies, and even at max settings, the beautify tool proves competent without being overbearing. Video quality. Across both cameras, you only have the option of up to 720p HD resolution recording when it comes to video, and like stills, fine detail is still very much lacking. If the phone's lack of camera bump didn't tip you off, there's no hardware or software-based image stabilization either, so footage is as jerky as your hands are when filming. What's more, focus needs to be coaxed into refocusing between different subjects, and the stereo audio is just as underwhelming as the visuals. So despite leaving us underwhelmed, hopefully you found our Nokia 2 camera review useful. And if you want to know more about this phone, we've already got a tips and tricks video, and we have a review coming for you really soon on the Recombi YouTube channel. Don't forget to subscribe, hit that bell for notifications, and thanks for watching.